Hello viewers, welcome back. We have discussed about the tectonics of Karakoram region in previous lecture. Today we will discuss about the Chaghi magmatic belt. Chaghi magmatic belt is in the Balochistan province of Pakistan. The main features of the area are Chaghi hills and there are anticline, and after that there are Dalbandin trough. And another feature is Rasco G anticline, and after Rasco G anticline there are Kohe Sultan. In Makran range there are four arc basin. So there are four arc basin in Makran range, and after that there are Mashkel trough. Mashkel trough is in the Kharan basin, and the most recent sediments of the area are there in Kharan basin, and the feature is Mashkel trough. And the oldest rocks or lithology is in the Sinjarani volcanic group. So the youngest are Kharan basin and the oldest are Sinjarani volcanic group. And it is about 10 kilometers thick andesite. So in Sinjarani volcanic group there are andesites, and these are about 10 kilometers thick. And towards the Chaghi side, the thickness of these andesites is about 4 km. Sinjarani volcanic group is overlain by limestone, and the formation of limestone name is Hamai limestone. So Sinjarani volcanic is overlain by Hamai limestone. There are very high amount of intrusion in Chaghi magmatic belt, and the main rocks are diorite and granodiorite, which are the intrusive rocks. So there are very high amount of intrusion in the Chaghi magmatic belt, and the main proof of high intrusion is diorite and granodiorite. And in Rasco area, as I have told in earlier, that Rasco G anticline is there in magmatic belt or in the province of Balochistan. It is the third important feature of the area, which is Rasco G anticline. In Rasco G anticline, the oldest formation, or we can say that the oldest group, is Kochakki volcanic group. So the Kochakki volcanic group is the oldest group in Rasco area, and the thickness of the Kochakki volcanic group is about 6 km thickness. So the thickness of the Kochakki volcanic group is 6 km. As I have told you earlier in previous lectures, when I have discussed about the geography of Pakistan and geographical location and importance of Pakistan, I have told you that on the western side of Pakistan there are Afghanistan and Iran. So toward the Iranian border there are Jazak formation, and the age of the Jazak formation is Paleocene. And another formation is Rakhshani formation. And the Rakhshani formation, the age of the Rakhshani formation is Paleocene, and there are turbidites are present in Rakhshani formation. The Rasco flitch belt is highly deformed. There are Marjava flitch belt, and in Marjava flitch belt and Rasco flitch belt, these both are highly deformed. There are high amount of thrusting, and about 1.5 km thick ophiolitic fragments are present in Rasco and Mirjava flitch belt. So it is the important feature about the deformation of the Rasco and Mirjava flitch belt, because there are 1.5 km thick ophiolitic fragments are present in both of the flitch belts. And these flitch belts are overlain by Kharan limestone, and the age of the Kharan limestone is Eocene. And viewers, there was thrusting in the area before limestone deposition. So we can identify, or we can see angular unconformity in the area. And I have told you in previous lecture, angular unconformity is evidence for tectonic activity. So there was thrusting in the area before deposition of limestone, and angular unconformity is there in the area of flitch belts. On the western side of Chaghi magmatic belt, There are very well-known formation due to the copper deposits, or I think about the gold deposits, which is a Sandec formation, and Sandec formation overlain by Amlo formation. So there are on the western part of the Chaghi magmatic belt, there are Sandec formation, which is overlain by Amlo formation, and the age of the Amlo formation is Oligocene, and the lithology of the Sandec formation is sandstone, and these are the cross-bedded sandstone. So it is the cross-bedded sandstone which are in the Sandec formation. So now we have discussed about the Chaghi magmatic belt and Roscoe G anticline. Roscoe G anticline, we also have discussed about it. Now I will discuss about the Dalbandin formation. We can say Dalbandin formation, and also we can say about Dalbandin trough. So the age of the Dalbandin formation is Miocene, and sometimes we can say that they are Dalbandin red formation. The lithology of the Dalbandin red formation is sandstone and conglomerate, and these are the continental deposits, and there are also the angular unconformity present. The youngest formation is a Kamrod formation. Between Kamrod and Dalbandin there are Dalil formation. So in the Dalbandin area, the youngest formation is Kamrod formation, and there are between Kamrod and Dalbandin there are Dalil formation. Dalil formation, the lithology of the Dalil formation is conglomerate, and in Kamrod formation there are lacustrine deposits. We can say that Lewis, if you know about Lewis, so you can identify Lewis, and so in Kamrod formation there are lacustrine deposits are there in Kamrod formation, and there are axillary prism which was grown with respect to time, and the oldest part of axillary prism is Roscoe Flitch belt. On the eastern side of Dalbandin formation there are Chaman fault. We will discuss in detail about the Chaman fault of the area in next lecture. And there are on the subduction zone, as there are subduction zone present in the area, and the one plate is Arabian plate and another is Indian plate. So the Indian plate is continental plate and Arabian plate is oceanic plate, which is subducting under the Indian plate. So on the subduction zone there are calcareous alkaline magmatism, and there are very huge deposits or fragment deposits of olistolith, and these are in turbidites. So olistolites are very huge fragments and which are deposited in turbidites of the area, and it is all about the Chaghi magmatic belt. So viewers, I hope you will enjoy all of these information about the Chaghi magmatic belt. And viewers, if you don't have subscribed my channel, so please subscribe my channel and like, and also share this video with your connections on social media or friends on YouTube with your subscribers. And again, remember that the book which is in front of my camera is not related to my topic. I am using this book just for the mask, or using as a mask for the video. So please don't try to focus on the text of the book and just focus on my voice. I will wait for your kind feedback about my efforts and my videos. Thank you.